Member for Vancouver Fairview.
Thank you, Honourable Speaker. Yesterday evening, the Jewish Community Centre of Greater Vancouver received an emailed bomb threat. The Leader of the Opposition and the Premier have both issued statements decrying this action, speaking out against hatred. I think it's important that we take a moment in this House to reflect on what it means and to add our voices to opposition to any act of hatred, any act of racism. This particular bomb threat was a hoax, but it could just as easily have been real, as we've seen in Canada, as we've seen in other parts of the world. Unfortunately, Honourable Speaker, some of us may have been lulled for a period of time into believing that hatred, anti-Semitism, Islamophobia, racism was declining in our world. But we have seen in recent years across the world, across North America, across Canada, and here in British Columbia, an increase, a recent emboldening of people who think they have license to express hatred, license to cause injury, license to threaten, license to tell good Canadians that they don't belong here. Honourable Speaker, the Jewish community today is understandably living in fear, just as the Muslim Canadian community is also living in fear, just as others have lived in fear over the years. Honourable Speaker, in the 1930s in Germany, we saw what happened when people treated acts of hatred, acts of racism, acts of anti-Semitism as an isolated incident. We know what happens, Honourable Speaker, when good people don't do enough, when good people think it's enough to simply express dismay to their friends, to their neighbours. Today and every day, it's important that we reach out to the Jewish community, to the Muslim community, to any community in Vancouver, across BC, or across Canada who has experienced hatred, who's experienced threats, and who live in fear. It's not enough to talk to our friends. Good people can make a difference by speaking loudly, by speaking publicly, and by speaking often, and I know every member of this House joins me in doing so today. Thank you very much.